Hello, friends. Welcome. Today we're going to be talking about dream state, which, you know, when we're asleep, what spiritual states the mind goes into. You know, it does alter states of and different modes of mind, and interaction of spirit sometimes in sleep state in your dreams, and also, you know, a little bit about astral projection. So, I mean, you know, sleep state is many believe, you know, is a different state of spirit whereby they believe that we travel out, you know, into the realms of spirit and we continue our evolution and work in the spirit realm. In most cases, pretty much unlikely that that happens. But we do have interaction sometimes, some people, the odd person, with spirit in our dreams. So, there's also astral projection. I mean, of course, you know, most people that do have astral projection, and many try it in meditation and find they get to the vibration and paralysis state. They find their eyes are opening and, you know, they don't quite get out of body or partially out of body and then back in again straight away. So very difficult to achieve in meditation. A few can do it. Most achieve astral projection in sleep state. It's an experience of the spirit, isn't it? Astral projection, it's the spirit traveling out of body. So that's when it happens most. Of course, when we're consciously asleep and not thinking about it, it's the spirit mind doing those things. Anyway, so, you know, sleep state, or, you know, while we're asleep, certain things can interact with us, because as we go to sleep is a perfect time for spirit to communicate, because we're halfway between conscious and halfway between sleep. Just in that little phase before you go to sleep, it's a very good time for spirit to communicate to us, so you can get feelings, thoughts, experiences, images on your mind as you're drifting off to sleep. So that's a great time for spirit to come and interact with us, loved ones, occasionally spirit guides and such like. But, you know, we go into REM during our sleep and have dreams. You know, sometimes we remember them, sometimes we don't. But that also is a perfect opportunity for spirit to interact with us. And you can go on a mental journey without going out of body, you know, into the spirit realm. And, you know, or realms of spirit, wherever that be, the astral plane or wherever it might be. But sometimes nothing more than imagination that spirit's giving you to take you to a place, you know, maybe full of crystal pyramids or something. Could be anything. Or to teach you a lesson, you know, take you upon an experience that you might enjoy. So different things spirit can do when we are in sleep state, in an REM and rapid eye movement. So, you know, that's beneficial to us. Now, my advice, you know, if you are having what you believe is, and it's part your own dream, it's part your own subconscious imagining, having a dream, and part spirit sometimes. Quite often it's just your own imagination having dreams, nothing to do with spirit whatsoever. But maybe for the right type of person and sort of spiritually inclined a little bit, that spirit will come and interact with us. And, you know, sometimes you wake up and you think, well, you know, I know that was my imagination, but there's things in there that I couldn't have thought of, didn't know nothing about whatsoever, that I was given in that dream that I've just had, that sleep state experience that I've just had, that I know didn't come from my own mind because I knew nothing about this thing. So some outside force has put that into my mind, probably a spirit guide or angel. So, you know, you can interact with spirit in dreams, yes, and you can go upon journeys. Now, my advice is, if you do believe you're interacting in your sleep with spirit or going on astral projection or journeys or whatever it might be, is to always protect yourself before you go to bed. Put a shield of light around yourself. But the other thing that's important for us all to do, you know, everybody, no matter what, whether you have experiences or not, if you're happy to, that is. Because spirit don't presume mostly to work with us unless we firstly ask. So if you're a good dreamer and you do want spirit to work with you, you've got to ask, say, come and, you know, give me some experiences while I'm dreaming, maybe. That is your personal choice whether to do that or not. But the one thing you must really always ask for, no matter what, is to have a gatekeeper there. And gatekeepers are there to protect you and to keep you safe on any kind of spiritual experience, whether it's a dream, and our interaction with spirit, whether it's astral projection, whether it's meditation, whether it's healing, whether it's just sitting at home, not wanting anything to do with spirit, and one comes along and starts talking to you that you don't want. They are there to protect us from intrusion and intrusion of our minds, or unwanted spirit not being coming to us that we don't want to hear from, negative spirit, evil spirit even, because like here, you know, in the spirit realm, it's not that much different than the next plane. There are good people and the bad people, and there's some very evil people too, and some very highly evolved spirit as well. So there's a mixture of all sorts of people there. So to ask for a gatekeeper is more just a prudent thing to do, because if you don't ask, you don't receive, and that's the way it is. So always make sure you protect yourself, but you can ask for additional protection, and hopefully there's a lot more to come soon, that whereby they've got greater powers to protect us, because some people do find themselves vulnerable to getting negative spirit come to them. And at the moment, although we have gatekeepers, there's little they can do to drag their spirit away. Hopefully in the next year or two, they will be able to actually attach themselves to those spirit and just drag them away, and they're dealt with by the authorities from within the spirit realm that are here upon the earth present, you know, to deal with those that spirit that are doing mischievous things. So it's always good to ask for protection. And when you're in sleep state, it's your imagination that spirit's using while you're dreaming. They're joining in and giving your imagination input from their perspective, and so they're using your mind. And quite often you find a spirit will give very symbolic meanings, you know, and you don't know what they mean, but you've got to, you know, sit about, think about it and see what it means. One day you see a very wavy sea, you know, and you're saying, oh, what does that mean? And it can mean really upset emotions. Seeing a really big wavy sea can mean upset emotions, for instance. And, you know, you say, well, yes, there is somebody around me, or I'm like that at the moment, very emotionally up in the air. Or you can see a lovely calm sea means settled emotions and things like that. So symbolic, you know what I mean? You've got to figure out the meaning of the thing. So also they might give you a feather. You know, you go, oh, feather, what does that mean? Well, you could use it for writing, or it might be a feather in your cap. It could mean several different things. So it's for us to figure out what these things mean. So they do greatly work symbolically, because to tell us exactly what they want to say to us is very difficult sometimes, but they can show us an image of a feather quite easily. So that's why they do it. They work with you in the way that you can receive what they're giving, you know. So they can't speak to you aloud and say, well, this feather I was going to give you, well, throw that away, I'll just tell you instead. So, I mean, it's development within ourselves to keep progressing now. Most people that have spiritual experiences sense and feel things and perceive understandings, intuition, rather than hearing, you know, understandable thoughts. Now, when spirit work with you in any way, they're using your subconscious, so it percolates to your conscious mind a thought of what it meant, you know, and you're trusting its spirit. Or the very rare medium can hear them, you know, verbally hear a spirit in their mind talking. So that's about the greatest achievement. So there's many different ways that spirit work with you, and, you know, it's being open to it, and, you know, meditating as well is very good for you. But, you know, in sleep state, that's the way it can happen. You know, you can get help quite often. If you want it, you should ask for it first. But you don't have to. You know, some spirit presume you're okay to have experiences. They can be loved ones. They can be spirit guides. They might be angels or other types of spirit. You might get a dolphin. You might get animal guides. You might get all sorts come to you in your sleeping state. And, you know, you've got to look, what did that mean? If you didn't understand what it mean, you got to look for the symbolic meaning. For instance, you see a big white horse, you know, and he's big and strong and everything, and you don't know what it means. But you look at the qualities of a horse and you're saying, powerful, you know, and white, is purity, you know what I mean, a great spiritual strength or evolution, you know, that you're doing well. And it's a symbol to you that you're doing well, you've got strength and you're pursuing this thing and you're becoming of light. So you look for the different meanings of different things. Anyway, I hope that's a bit insightful to you. Have a good day. Love and light. Sheb, a.k.a. Neil.